what? You might say to yourself, that's nice.
That's nice.
You don't really recognize it, though. That's because you've never heard it before. It is brand new. It is from Bross, and it is called Love Can Make You Fly, and it is the first time anyone's heard it.
Yeah,
first time anyone has heard it.
Really nice.
Happy about what? How would you describe that, guys?
Bit of Northern Soul, like a bit of Northern Soul, trying to make people feel good. There's a lot of heavy stuff in the news around the world. We just wanted to create a song that was, you know, full of love and gave. Actually, we mentioned 37 Crawford Road, and for me and my brother, that's where we really felt we were at home.
I think everybody has their beginning, don't they? And the memories were the simplicity of things, you know, the Sunday roast with the family and the memories. And I think we actually just revisited for a documentary doing at the moment together where it all started for us.
We just wanted to get everybody in the mood. We didn't even want a big fanfare before we speak to you.
Yeah.
We just want to fade that in,
it's
talk to the boys, do the competition, and get back and talk more because Bross,
yeah, you heard it,
Bross are back in the building.
ITV makes over 300 winners every year. That's people just like you receiving an amazing phone call from our Winners HQ.
Delivering the news feels incredible. It makes me feel happy, makes them feel happy.
I was glad I was sitting down because I couldn't believe I actually won it.
I thought, what was ITV ringing me for? It was, wow, mind-boggling. I just didn't think I would ever win.
So once the competition closes, don't ignore your phone because it could be me ringing you.
And this week, you have another chance to enter our incredible competition to win £70,000 and your very own convertible. Come on, who doesn't enjoy their top down in the sunshine? For another chance to win, text prize to 86060. Text costs £2 plus one standard network rate message. Go to the website. Entries cost £2. Call 09068 786 060. Calls cost £2 plus your network access charge. Or post your name and phone number to DY30 PO Box 7558 Derby DE10NQ. Entrance must be 18 or over. Lines close at 3 p.m. on Friday the 25th of August. Good luck.
Thank you, Ian. Well, they say good things come to those who wait, don't they? Well, Brossettes across the world, and they are across the world because Leah says, I'm in Australia waiting to see this, and they've been waiting 25 years.
Come on, how many of you are sitting at home there bopping along to that, bringing you back in time? Because that Matt and Luke, and welcome back, it's lovely to see you, is the soundtrack to a lot of people's lives and happy times for a lot of people.
Well, thank you for having us, really. Thank you.
That means a lot. I mean, we're inundated. We're back in London. It's just to have people coming up, and it's just, we're inundated with memories. And oh, I met my wife, I met my husband, we did this, and it's just incredible.
And we're rehearsing right now, obviously, for the show. We go straight there after this interview, and the fans are out there, and they're telling us that, you know, don't feel bad about us waiting outside, because all of our circle of friends and the camaraderie and our lifelong friends we have are from the band. So it's a real honour, you know.
But look, when you say you're rehearsing, I mean, will you still have the same energy? I'm not suggesting you shouldn't or wouldn't, but we all get old. I mean, you look at you guys there, you were from 18 years of age upwards. Is it the same high intensity on stage?
Yeah, well, Matt's been on stage for 30 years. For me, it's a new experience, and frankly, I can't wait to see the fans again. But I don't know about Matt, but I feel more energised now and more free and happy and joyful about the experience than I could, not even close to when I was a child. Now it's a true, fun experience.
Because you've been acting, but you carried on. You've been in Vegas, haven't you, for,
nine-year residency now, yeah. And just I'm negotiating with another big casino. They know who they are, and I've seen the room, but I can't wait to make that announcement. But, yeah, I mean, to be back on stage and rehearsing with Luke, it's up and down, but the excitement to actually just be able to.
So what made you, though, after 25 years, who had the conversation? How did that come about that you said, come on, it's time to do it, let's get back and perform together?
It's been going on for some time, hasn't it? But it just felt right, and I think we both felt comfortable where we were in our lives, and I think it was clear we didn't need to do it, but it just seemed, for me personally, I can't speak for Matt, but like, why on earth are we not doing this?
Yeah.
I was coming to London to do Wembley, and I said to my brother, I said, look, you know, why don't I go and talk to Live Nation and said, if, are they up for it? And he went, yeah, go in. And so I went in, proposed that we reunite, and they were totally up for it, and we, within 3 months of that conversation, we had the tickets from sale.
You know, I've kept tabs on you. A lot of people have kept tabs on you over the years. I've seen you pop up in various movies things like that, and I know what you were up to as well. Is there any part of you that look back on the past 25 years and think at all that they were wasted years, or what? How do you reflect on the last 25
years? There'll be two answers on this.
Yeah. I mean, I have to say, I mean, I've done 9 years straight as a headliner in Vegas. That's 2 years longer than I was in Bros. And I've learned more as an entertainer outside of Bros, if I'm being
honest. So not wasted for you?
No, I just loved it. I mean, I've learned more than ever, but I'm about to learn even more.
Give us the other two answers.
For me, you know, I've been through ups and downs, and reinvention is a real struggle for many of us who have done it in our lives, and you've been wonderfully successful, and I've seen you also thrive, and congratulations.
Thank you very much. We go back a long way. I mean, I was young, they were young, it was the 80s, whatever. But
I'm as a result of that journey, and I'm thankful for it, so I wouldn't change a thing.
Nice to be able to say that, you know, because I think you'll do interview after interview where people will try and put a wedge between you you're solid.
Well, we're brothers, we fight, we do, but you know, there's a creative strength for both of us. And I think to think you can have a creative collaboration without butting heads is, it means you're not striving for excellence. So, but that said and done, we adore each other. We play video games together. We're goofy as ever, as we've always been.
And,
you know?
And we started there before we went to the competition. You were saying that a lot of the writing is taking you back sometimes to your childhood, talking about the home where you grew up.
Yeah, I mean, we moved so many times. It was actually a tumultuous upbringing in many ways, and we moved too many times, if I'm honest. But 37 Crawford Road, for both me and Luke, was a place of absolute joy. It was a soul house. You know, everything from Cream to Stevie Wonder to Donny Hathaway.
Deep Purple.
Thin Lizzy, all this music, and Frank Sinatra was coming out at 37 Crawford Road.
And was that your mum? Was she a music lover?
It was my granddad, my mum's dad, and my Aunt Sally. My Aunt Sally is the reason, I have to say, is probably the reason I'm singing, because she just flooded us with great music.
She gave us boxes of 45s of like Gladys Knight and the Pips and music that we would have missed. But yeah.
Ruth does a very good Gladys Knight.
I can do Gladys and the Pips.
I can do the Pips. Listen, everybody. Lynn, they've matured into two fine specimens, haven't they? Janine, I'm heading to London next Saturday. I cannot wait to see them. We should say tickets are still available for the 20th of August, right?
Yes.
19th at the O2 sold out. There still is tickets for the 20th. The new single is Love Can Make You Fly. It comes out on the 18th, okay? Pre-order, you can pre-order that from midnight tonight.
Talking about your fans, I mean, so many people getting in touch here.
Are you amazed they're still
Tracy,
there?
Yes.
Tracy says, I loved Bros so much that before I'd go out with any of my boyfriends, they had to look like them.
Good girl. Well done.
Julie says, I'm so excited to see them, I literally could spontaneously combust.
Please don't.
Hello, Amanda. I'm screaming with excitement, says Amanda. I feel like a teenager again. Absolutely brilliant. Now, we've got some VT of fans, haven't
we?
Yes, we have.
This picture was taken way back in the early 90s when Luke went to This Morning at the Albert Dock. Luke, you look hot. I do not.
I actually own a candle business. I have a matte candle, which it smells like matte.
We would queue overnight, whether it was raining, whether it was snowing.
I also have a Luke candle.
One of the best pieces that I have has to be this, which I'm sure you recognise as a piece of your fence from when you lived in Commercial Way.
Many of us also had our lovely handmade banners out of old sheets, tinsel and paint, waving away and dancing to all your songs.
There you go. She never got it signed all those years ago. The thing is, there it is. How wonderful is that?
This is for Jenny, and she used to carry
this. It's like the Dead Sea Scrolls, this is.
Jenny used to carry this around to all your concerts and always hoping to get it signed by you, and she never managed it.
Well, I'll leave you to sign that.
And we'll be doing all the old songs as well that everyone loves, as well as the new stuff.
Absolutely, everything.
Yeah. Matt, look, absolutely brilliant to see you back. And do you know what? It's brilliant to see you so happy, so looking forward to this, and bringing that joy back into so many people's lives.
You've got to come.
We'll come.
Yeah, yes. I want to say thank you also for being so supportive as well. It's not expected, so thank you.
Good, man. Thank you very much indeed. There you are. We'll do it again tomorrow at 10.